tangents and secants to a circle. Tangents and secants to a circle. Now, before going to discuss about tangents and secants to a circle, now, for what is circle? What is the parts of the circle? Now, take what is circle? Circle means the collection of all the points in a plane. The collection of all the points in a plane which are at a fixed distance from a fixed point. Which are at a fixed distance from a fixed point is called a circle. The collection of all the points in a plane which are at a fixed distance from a fixed point is called as circle. Now take the collection of all the points means these one of the plane. The collection of all the points in a plane from a fixed point. From a fixed point means this fixed point. From a fixed distance means now you take this distance, this distance, this distance, this distance, this distance. Like this, any distance take, all is constant, is it? Now, this is R means, these are R. For example, center is O. Here, O is the fixed point, it is called as center of the circle. Now, R is the fixed distance, it is called as radius of the circle. Now, what is circle? The collection of all the points in a plane which are at a fixed distance from a fixed point is called a circle. The fixed point is called as center of the circle and the fixed distance is called as radius of the circle. Now, what is diameter means? Now, this one take. Now, this length is now. The twice of the radius is called as diameter. Diameter D is equals to. D is equals to 2R. What is diameter means? In any circle, the twice of the radius. Is called as diameter. If the radius is given, then find the diameter means. Formula is D is equals to 2R. For example, if diameter is given, then how to find the radius? Now, D equal to 2R is it? Now, here R is multiplying with 2. Take left side means it is dividing. Okay, what will come? R is equals to D by 2. This is the formula to find radius if diameter is given. Then next one is what is chord? Now what is chord means? The line segment which cuts the any given circle at two different points. Is called as chord. Chord is always be line segment only, not line. Line means no end points, but line segment has two end points. Now what is chord means? Let's see. For example, this one of the circle take. This one of the circle at center O. Now you see. Now this is the one of the line segment. It cuts the circle at two distant points. For example, P and Q. Here P and Q are called as line segment is called as chord of the circle. What is chord means? The line segment which cuts the any given circle at two distant points is called as chord of the circle. And then next one is what is arc of the circle? Arc means the part of the any circle. The part on the any circle is called as arc. The part on the any circle means this one of the circle at center O. Now take for example divide this with many parts like this. Now here these what you see between these two parts, this one arc, and from here to here is one arc, here to here is one arc. Like this, what is arc means? The part on the any circle is called as arc. Okay, then next one is what is segment? What is segment? No, segment means now first discuss about only segment and then what are the different types of segments. Now first one is minor segment, second one is major segment. Okay, now what is segment means? The area bounded by one chord and one arc is called as segment. The area bounded by one chord and one arc is called as segment of the circle. The area bounded by one chord and one arc. Now take this one of the circle. This is one of the circle is there now with center O. Now for example this one chord take. PQ is the chord. And now this is the one of the chord and this is one of the segment. So this is called as, this is called as, what, this is one of the segment. This is one of the segment. Now again take this one of the chord and this one of the arc. Now this also another segment. This also another segment. This also another segment. There are only two segments possible in any circle. There are only two possible segments are possible in any circle. What are them? See, how means? One is minor segment, second one is major segment. Now first discuss about only segment. What is segment means? The area bounded by one chord and one arc is called as segment of the circle. One chord and one arc is called as segment of the circle. And the next one is, first one, minor segment. What is minor segment? Minor segment, take. Minor segment is, now for example this one of the circle with center O. Now it is, this is one of the chord PQ. One of the chord PQ. Now what is segment means? You know already. Now what is minor segment? Okay. If the arc is minor arc, now what is minor segment means? If the arc is minor arc, then the area bounded by line segment, then the area bounded by line segment means what will come? Chord. So then the area bounded by chord and the arc is called as minor segment. If the arc is minor arc, minor means what? Smaller arc. Now here see, this is the smaller arc. But up is larger arc is it now. Now this smaller arc only take. What is arc? Minor segment means, if the arc is minor arc, if the arc is minor arc, then the area bounded by, then the area bounded by chord and the arc is called as minor segment. So this is the minor segment. This is minor segment. And next one, most important point is the angle in the minor segment is always be obtuse angle. The angle in the minor segment is always be obtuse angle. Now you see, for example, like this take. Here angle will come. Here angle. This angle is always be greater than 90 degrees and less than 180 degrees. This angle is always be greater than 90 degrees and less than 180 degrees. Now what is segment? Minor segment, but angle is always be more. What means how much? Between 90 and 180 degrees. The angle in the minor segment is always be obtuse angle. Okay. And then next one is major segment. Major segment. Now this one of the circle with center O. Okay. Now this PQ is one of the chord. Okay. Now take any one like this. Now this angle is. Now first discuss about what is major segment. If the arc is major arc, then the area bounded by the chord and the major arc is called as major segment. Major arc is called as major segment. If the arc is major arc, if the arc is major means what? Larger arc. Now see here, this is the larger arc from here to here. This is the major arc. Major arc. And then next one is, this is called as major. Now what is major segment means? The area bounded by, the area bounded by major segment, sorry, major arc and the chord. Major arc and the chord is called as major segment. Major segment. Now in one here also, one most important concept is, now yeah, the angle in the any major segment is always be this obtuse angle. Obtuse angle. Here is acute angle. Acute angle means what? Greater than 0 degrees. Now what? Less than 90 degrees. Always be acute angle. The angle in the major segment is always be acute angle. Means what? Less than 90 degrees. Less than 90 degrees. Okay, these are the most important concepts. What are they means? The angle in the minor segment is always be obtuse angle. And the angle in the major segment is always be acute angle. Okay. And the next one is, what is half circle or semicircle? Okay, semicircle. Now, half of the any circle is called as semicircle. Half of the any circle is called as semicircle. Okay, now take this one of the semicircle. This one of the semicircle. Now at center is O. At center is O. Half of the any circle is called as semicircle is called now. Now here also one most important concept is the angle in the semicircle is always be right angle. The angle in the semicircle is always be right angle. Okay, how means, you see, like this straight. Now draw any semicircle. Draw any semicircle and take, draw any one line, any lines, any triangle like this straight. Here is compulsory angle is 90 degrees will come. Angle is exactly 90 degrees will come. So, the angle in the any semicircle is always by 90 degrees. In the semicircle means 90 degrees. But the angle in the semicircle at the center is always a straight angle. This equals to 180 degrees. At the center, at the center means this angle is always be 180 degrees. The angle in the semicircle means always be right angle, which is equals to 90 degrees. But the angle in the semicircle at the center is always be straight angle, which is equals to 180 degrees. And next concept is, next one is, the angle in the same segments are always be equal. The angle in the same segments are always be equal. How means, now for example, this one take, this topic take. This one of the segment. The angle in the same segments are equal now. Now, for example, like this take. Now, like this also take. Like this. Now here, if this angle is 120 degrees means this angle also same will come. This angle also same. The angle in the same segments are always by equal. This same segment. The angles also same. Like this also take. For example, this angle is 30 degrees take. 30 means like this angle straight. Like this take. Like this one. And like this one take. Or like this also take, no problem. Here, this angle, all angles are always be 30 degrees only will come. Not only here, this one also take, here 90 degrees is there now. Here like this take 90 degrees, here right, here also 90 degrees will come. Or like this also take, like this, here also 90 degrees will come. So what is the, this, how means the angle in the same segments are always be equal. For example, take this one of the circle. At center O, the like this is given. Now this one, this is like this is given. Now this 50 degrees is given. This P is given. This 50 degrees is given. This P is given. Now find the value of P means how to find. Same answer will come. How means the angle in the same segments are always be equal. The angle in the same segments are always be equal. So this one also equal to 50 degrees. This one also equals to 50 degrees. Okay. Next, what is the area of circle and perimeter of circle and area of semicircle and perimeter of semicircle and area of minor segment and measure of and area of satire also will come and measure of area of major segment. Now first take a circle. This one of the circle with center O. Area formula is this radius. This is diameter. Is area formula pi r square. Area of circle formula pi r square. Now put the perimeter of circle formula 2 pi r. Here from here to here, from here to here, this length is pi r will come. This length is pi r. From here to here, this length is pi r will come. Pi r plus pi r, 2 pi r is the perimeter of the circle. Now what is perimeter means? We are taking only boundaries, measurement of only boundaries, but not taking the diameter. But this is not boundary, this one only boundaries. So pi r plus pi r equal to 2 pi r. But now take this one. This center O is semicircle. Now area is equal to pi r square by 2. Area is equal to pi r square by 2. Now how to find perimeter? Now this smaller. Now p is equal to, now this length how much is there? This length is pi r is there. So this is pi r. This is pi r. Now what is boundaries? Now in this semicircle means this one also boundary will come. This one also boundary will come. Then take the pi r plus r, 2r. Pi r plus 2r. Pi r plus 2r. Then p is equal to pi plus 2 into r. Here r is taking common. Pi plus 2 into r. So this is the perimeter of the semicircle formula. Then what is sector? What is sector means? The area bounded by two radii and one north is called as sector of the circle. The area bounded by two radii and one arc is called as sector of the circle. Now for example, this one of the circle take. This one of the circle with center O. Now this one arc. This one arc take. This one arc. Now this is called as sector of the circle. This is the sector of the circle. This also written as like this also, no problem. Like this. Or like this also will come. These two radius, this one arc. These are two radius, these are one arc. What is sector? The area bounded by two radii and one arc is called as sector of the circle. The area formula A is equal to x by 360 into pi r square. X degrees by 360 degrees into pi r square is the formula to find area of the sector. Here x degrees is called the angle of the center. Angle of the sector or the center. So this one, this is the x degrees. This is the x degrees. What is x degrees means? The angle of the sector or the center. Then listen. Area of sector formula x by 360 into pi r square. Now this is one arc. This length L. Length of arc is L. Then perimeter of sector formula P is equal to L plus 2r. L plus 2r is the perimeter of sector formula. And then next one is how to find area of minor segment and area of major segment. Area of minor segment and area of major segment. Then take area of minor segment means this one of the circle take. This center O, this PQ. Okay, now this minor segment. How to find this area means? Now take this one. This one of the triangle. This is one of the triangle. This theta take. Theta r x. Now how to find the area of minor segment is area of minor segment. For example, this AB take. AB take. Okay, segment Z equals to, now this one is there now, how to find this one means total minus this one. Total minus this one means, this one means this area will come. Now total means what? Area of sector. This one x one take. X is area of sector minus. Well, OAB means what? OAB is one of the triangle. So area of triangle. Area of sector formula. X degrees by 360 degrees into pi r square minus area of triangle formula half into AB. This is the formula to find area of minor segment. Okay, now what is the area of minor segment formula means? The area of sector minus area of triangle. How to find this area means? Take this area, total area minus this area, remove from that area, this area will come. Then how to find major segment area? Major segment means what? From here to here, this area, this total area. How to find major segment means? Now this circle is it, this circle, this center O. Now this area means how to find means total area minus this area means this area will come. So what is question? What is answer? How will come answer means the area of circle, the area of major segment is equals to area of minor segment. You know already what is area of circle? Pi r square. Area of circle is pi r square will come. Then area of minor segment is area of circle, area of sector minus area of triangle. First find area of minor segment. How much will come? How, what is the formula? Area of sector minus area of triangle. And then find area of circle. Area of circle pi r square formula. Well, you know, if you know this one and this one, now substitute in this one. Area of major segment will come. These are the areas of minor segment, major segment, and area of circle, semicircle, and area of sector. And then next one is a line and a circle. What is tangents? What is secants? Okay. Tangent, submit a line on a circle. A line. Okay, now a line on a circle. Now take any one circle with center O. This one of the circle with center O. Now this one line, this one of the line PQ. PQ is one of the line. This is first case. In second case, this circle O, this line PQ. This O center. This second case. And third case, this is circle O. This is the line PQ. If you take a line on a circle, there are three possibilities. How many possibilities? Three possibilities. In first case, the line neither touches nor intersects with circle. In second case, the line touches at only one point on the circle. That point is called the line is called as tangent, and the point is called as point of contact. If any line touches only one point on the circle, then the line is called as tangent, and the point is called as point of contact. And in third case, the line intersecting the circle at two distinct points. The line intersecting the circle at two distinct points, then the line is called as secant. What is secant means? If any line that intersects any circle at two different points or two distinct points is called as secant of the circle. Secant of the circle. The word tangent is, the word tangent is derived from the Latin word. Tangent is Latin word. Latin word tangere. Tangere. Which means to touch. Which means to touch. Means the word tangent is derived from the Latin word tangere, which means to touch. Which was introduced by the Danish mathematician. Danish mathematician Thomas Finck. Thomas Finck in 1583. Country is Danish mathematician. Which was introduced by the Danish mathematician Thomas Finck in 1583. And the second one is what? Second. The word second is derived from the Latin word secare. Secare. The word second is derived from the Latin word secare. Secare. Which means to cut. Which means to cut. So what is the meaning of secant means? Secant means cut. Tangent means touch. Okay. And then next one. And then how many tangents are possible to a circle? How many tangents are possible to a circle? Okay. This one understand now. What does tangent means? If any line that touches the only one point on the circle, then the circle is then the less. Line is called as tangent of the circle and the point is called as point of contact. And the secant means if any line that intersects the any circle at the two distinct points, then the line is called as secant of the circle. Secant of the circle. Then next one is how many tangents are possible to a circle? How many tangents are possible to a circle? For example, this one of the circle. How many tangents are possible to a circle means? Infinity tangents. How means? This one of the tangent. Okay. This one of the tangent. Like this. Like this, many tangents will come. To a circle means how many tangents are possible to a circle means there are infinity tangents possible to a circle. For next case, how many tangents are possible to a circle? On a point of the circle means only one tangent. Now, your how many tangents? Infinity tangents. Infinite. For example, this one of the circle take. Any one point here is a. Here is the point A. How many tangents are possible to a circle? On your point B on the circle means there are only one tangent. This point P. Here point is not given. In this case, points are not given. How many tangents are possible to a circle is given? So what is the answer? Infinity tangents. But here only one point P on the circle is given. How many tangents are possible means only one tangent. Then next case, how many tangents are possible to a circle if point is outside? For example, this one of the circle. Here point is there. This point is there. How many tangents are possible means there are two tangents are possible to a circle. If a point is outside the circle, there are two tangents. How many tangents are possible to a circle? If the point is outside the circle means there are two possible tangents. In next case, for example, this one of the circle, this point P. Okay, how many tangents are possible to a circle? If a point P is inside a circle means zero tangents or tangents are impossible. Zero tangents. Why? Because if a point is inside the circle, then if you draw a line, that will become secant. Now for example, here see, this point is here now, draw a line like this. What will come? This secant, not a tangent. If any point is inside a circle, if I draw a line, that will become always with secant, not tangents. So how many tangents are possible means zero tangents. Zero tangents are possible. And then next case, now if a point is outside the circle is there, if a point is outside the circle, then the length of the tangents drawn from the from the outside the circle is always be equal. For example, this point A take, this point is B take. Now PA is equals to PB. PA is equals to PB. These two lengths are always be equal. The length of tangents drawn from a external point to the circle is always be equal. The length of tangents drawn from a external point of the circle are always be equal. Like this, any point take, not only line, any point take, this one of the tangents means this also same. This PA is equals to PB will come. Like this also take. For example, this one of the circle, this one of the point P, this A take, this B take, this length also same will come. PA is equals to PB. What is that one means? The length of the tangents drawn from the external point to a circle are always be equal. Always be equal. And then next one is the radius of the inner circle is always be perpendicular to the tangent of the circle. The radius of the inner circle is always be perpendicular to the tangent of the circle. For example, this one of the circle, this tangent means the radius is compulsory, 180 degrees will come. Like this, the radius, this tangent PQ, the radius of the circle is always be perpendicular to the tangent of the circle. For example, like this. Now, your tangent is like this, is a tangent. Now, this point P, this. Okay, now like this will come. This, this R. Here also, 90 degrees will come. 90 degrees. Now, in any case, the tangent of the circle is always be perpendicular to the radius of the circle. Okay, and then next one is. For example, this one of the circle, this is A, B, C, this is center O, here a circle is inscribed in a triangle, and this length is 2, this length is 3, this length is 4 is given. This length is 2, this length is 3, this length is 4 is given. Then find the perimeter of the circle. Now what is question? You see, this circle, the length of tangents drawn from a external point to a circle is always be equal now. So like this will come, that one. Like this will come. Now this A means this P, B. These P, both are equal will come now. Now this one also take, this one of the external point C. Now these one tangent and these one tangent. So these four means these also four will come. These four means these also four. Now these one is one of the external point. Now this is 3 means these also 3. These one of the external point, these two, these also 2. Then what will come? 2 plus 3, this length is 5. 3 plus 4, this length is 7. 2 plus 6, this length is 6. Then add all. How much will come? 5 plus 6 plus 7 is equals to 18. 18 is the perimeter of the circle. 18 is the perimeter of the circle. Half perimeter means by 2, 9 will come. Centimeters means centimeters, meters means meters. Okay, and then next one is Okay, next one is, for example, if it's this one of, now if it's If a circle touches all the four points of a quadrilateral, if a circle touches all the four points of a quadrilateral, then AB plus AB, this side plus this side, CD equal to BC plus AD or AD plus BC. If a circle touches all the four sides of a quadrilateral, then formula is AB plus CD is equals to AD plus BC. This is the formula. And then next one is, for example, this one of the circle take. Now in this case, if P is external point and AP and AQ are two tangents, then this angle is equal to angle PAQ. Angle PAQ is equal to 2 into angle OPQ, this angle overcomes AC once. Now this tangent, this center means a rectangle will come. Here also rectangle will come. This center. Now take one line like this means this angle will come, this angle will come. So 2 into angle OPQ. OPQ is equal to 2 into angle OQP. OQP. Now if any one point is, if any one point A is outside the circle and AP, AQ are tangents, then angle APQ, PAQ is equal to 2 into angle OPQ is equal to 2 into angle OQP. Okay, and then next one is, for example, you take any one circle like this only, same circle like this. Now, like this. Okay, here see, this one of the circle with center O, this one of the external point A. Like this tangents like this take. Okay, now here is like this will come now. This PQ, here is angle is theta means your angle is 180 minus theta. If your angle is theta, then your angle almost will come 180 minus theta. Your angle is theta means your angle almost will come 180 minus theta. For example, here is angle 60 means your angle almost will come 120 degrees. Here is 60 degrees angle means 60 degrees. Then here is 180 minus 60 is how much? 120 degrees. And also, here is 120 means here how much will come? Here is 120 means here how much will come? Here 60 will come. 120 means here 60 will come. How will come this one? I already learned this one about this one in 9th class. What is that one means? The angle of the circle at the center is twice the angle of the center, angle of the circle at the any point on the circle, like this take. How will come is, see, this one of the circle like this take. Here is, like this is it, like this. Here is 60 means, here is 30 degrees. This already is in 9th class. And 9th class concept is this one. What is that one? The angle of the circle at the center is, twice of the angle of the circle at any part on the circle or any one point on the circle. This point on the circle P take. This center of the circle C O take. Now here 60 degrees means here 30 degrees. Double of this angle is this angle. For example, here is 150 degrees take. Here how much will come? 75 degrees. 75 2 is 150. For example, here is 50 degrees take. Here how much will come? Here is 100 degrees. here is 100 degrees. Similarly, here 100 degrees angle means here how much will come? 60 degrees angle. 60 degrees angle. And then next one is, Hello, sir. Two more questions is there. What that question means? What is that question? What is concentric circles? Concentric circles means concentric circles. The two or more number of circles with same center with different radius. The circles with same center and different radius are called as same center with different radius are called as concentric circles. Concentric circles. Now take this one of the circle and this another circle with center O. With center O but different radius. Okay. If I draw any, if I draw anywhere tangent to the back circle, that will become the tangent to the first circle. See, this circle is cutting two points at the back of the back circle. Second circle means touches the at only one point of the symbol, first circle. So in this one like this will come now. Here this length are equal. This lengths are basics. Which case? If second circle will become tangent to the first circle. If second of the second circle will become tangent of the first circle, then the radius bisects the second of the second circle. Bisects means what? Dividing two equal parts. So this one also same will come. For example, this one 4 means this one also 4. Total 8 will come. Now radius is 5 is given means then find this one. This one how much will come? 3 will come. Like this, one question will come. Okay, and then finding the area of more. Okay. What are them is? Now, area of, for example, this square. Yes. Area of S square formula. Area of square formula, S square. Then next one is, this L, B. Area of triangle. So, area of rectangle formula, L into B. Then area of circle, pi r square. Then area of semicircle formula is, pi r square by 2. Then area of like this half of the semicircle formula is pi r square by 4. Area of half of the semicircle formula is pi r square by 4. Then area of sector formula. Area of sector. This x degrees are x degrees take. X degrees means pi, sorry. X degrees by 360 degrees into pi r square. X degrees by 30 degrees into pi r square. Then area of triangle formula. Area of equilateral triangle. Area of equilateral triangle. If all sides are equal. If all sides are equal formula. Root 3 by 4 into a square. Root 3 by 4 into a square. And then area of equal, sorry. For example, these two sides given. This side are. Two sides are equal means what triangle will come? Isosceles triangle. Two sides are equal means isosceles triangle. Then if theta is given, if two sides is given, angle is given, then two sides is given. Then area, formula to find, area of isosceles triangle is half into r square sin theta. Half into r square sin theta. If two sides is given of a isosceles triangle and angle between two sides is given, angle between two equal sides is given. Equal sides only here, not this sides. Angle between two equal sides is given. Then area to find semicircle. Isosceles triangle is half into r square sin theta. And then next one is right angle triangle. This base, this height, this base. Then area to find right angle triangle is I is equals to half into base into height. Area to find rectangle triangle is half into base into height. And then next one is, for example, bounded figures. Bounded figures is given. You know all this, first listen. Area of square formula is square. Area of rectangle formula LB. Area of circle formula pi r square. Area of semicircle formula pi r square by 2, area of half of the semicircle formula, or this one pi r square by 4, then area of sector formula, x by 3 is equal to pi r square, area of equilateral triangle formula, if all sides are a, root 3 by 4 into a square, if all sides are x means root 3 by 4 into x square, and then next one is area of isosceles triangle, if 2 sides are given, equal sides are given, and angle between 2 equal sides is given, then answer is half into r square sin theta. For example, then next one, if area of rectangle triangle formula, base and height is given, half into base into height. For example, how to find the area of scalene triangle, like this is given scalene triangle. This A, B, C, then area formula A is equal to root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. This is also called as Heron formula to find the area of triangle, Heron's formula. Yeah, S means what? S means A plus B plus C by 2. A plus B plus C by 2 means half semi-perimeter or half perimeter. A, B, C are less sides of the triangle. A, B, C are sides of the triangle. Okay. And then next one. Bounded figures. Now like this take. This center. Like this semicircle will come. This center is it. Okay, then find this area. ABCD is given. ABCD is a square. Then find the area bounded in the figure means this one of the semicircle. What will come answer? Area of square minus area of circle. Yeah, because two semicircles become one circle. What will come answer? S square minus pi r square. And then next case take. Next case, same like this. This is one of the square, ABCD is one of the square. Like this one is it. Then find this area. This one of the square. This center. Okay. Like this is it. Now find this area means this two become one half circle, two half circles become one circle. Okay, if side is S means what will come answer? This one also S square minus pi r square. Area to find this area means S square minus pi r square. And then next case means this is circle, this is square, this is square. Then find this area, this circle overtake. Now what will come? Area of square minus area of circle, that's all. Area of square minus area of circle only will come now. What will come answer? A square minus pi r square will come. Why? Because total minus this one. Total minus this one. Before erase will come. But what is answer? S square minus pi r square. And then next two more important concepts are like this is given. Like this one is given. Now you have to find this area. How to find this area means first you have to find this area means how will come? Area of sector means 2 into pi r square by 4 minus pi r square by 4 2 into pi r square by 4 minus half into a square 2 into pi r square by 4 minus half into a square. How will come is, yes, see, this will come like this. Okay, here like C. And this one, 2 into pi r square 4 minus half into here 1 part is there, here 2 parts is there. So 2 into pi r square by 4 minus half into a square means what? Here you have circle, we have different this area means half into a square means what? We are removing this area. Half, here 2 circles, 2 squares is there. So removing one, this one and this one means half into a square will come. And then next one is last one, for example, like this is it. Find only this area. Take how to find this area? Okay, here how many parts is there? This one take 4 parts. For 2 parts, but this one how many is there? 2 into pi r square by half into a square. For this one only, what is answer? This one not answer, sir. Half into 2 into pi r square by 4 minus half into a square. If side is a, side is a. Here what will come answer? This one side is a means here 2, 4, 6, 8 parts will come. So what will come? 8 into pi r square by 4 minus half into yes, side is a means sorry, s square. Side is s means s square. If side is s means what will come? S square. Okay, and then remaining also more is there. What the term means? For example, this one other triangle is given. Now like this is given. Okay. Now find this area means A, B, C is given. C. Now take area of sector minus area. If this one is given and this one is given, then find area of sector minus area of triangle. This area will come. Okay. These are the topics or concepts in the tangents and secant square circle. Thank you.